Let's then look at how to read files in Python. I've just created a simple text file which consists of three lines. I'm first going to create a variable file name which contains the name of my input file. I'm just going to call this input.txt, which is the name of the file I just created. We can use for loops to read a file in Python. I'm going to type for line in open. And inside open, I'm going to insert the name of my file. What this does is the following. Open file name generates a file object. I can loop over file objects using the for statement. In this code, line will always contain one of the lines of the input file. Let's start with a simple example. Let's just print out the lines of the file. I'll just type print line, and Python will print out the contents of the file. We have three lines, first line, second line, and a third line. Let's look at one line of text in a little bit more detail. Consider a line of text that just says first. Now at the end of the line, although you don't see it, we always have a line break character. So if we have a Python string where line is equal to first, although you don't see this character, it's going to cause extra line breaks in subsequent processing of your text. There is a way to remove this character using the rstrip method. If you call line.rstrip, Python extracts the line feed character and leaves you with the first part of the string. Let's try using the rstrip method for strings. The method is called rstrip. I can call it by typing line.rstrip. Remember, strings are immutable. That means if I want to keep the result, I have to assign it either to a new variable or to the existing variable. I'm going to do a reassignment to line by typing line equals line.rstrip. If I now print out line and run the loop, you'll see the extra line breaks have disappeared. If we look at the code, line.rstrip returns a string. This means that I can just chain a new string function at the end of the line. I now have line.rstrip parentheses dot split parentheses. Inside the split as an argument, I have to provide the character that I want to use for splitting the line. In this case, I'm just going to use a white space. A key thing to realize about this is that the string split method returns not a string, but a list. So let's try to print out the output. In this case, Python has read through the entire text file. It has split every line wherever there is a white space, and it returns a list. Let's then take a look at how to write a text file line by line. Let's create the file object by typing open. First, we need the name of the file, which in this case is just going to be output.txt. When writing a file, we need a second argument which tells Python that we would like to create a file object for writing, not for reading. We indicate this by providing that second argument as a string, and the content of the string is simply just w. What this does is it creates a file object for writing to a file named output.txt. The next step for us is to capture this file object in some variable. Typically, this is called f. At this point, my file object has been opened, and I'm ready to start writing. Writing happens by using the method write, which is a method of the file object, in this case called f. So I type f.write, and I provide the string that I would like to write to my text file. Let's say we would like to write the word Python in our text file. We provide the input as a string, in this case Python. However, we have to add an extra character, which is the line break character that we extracted when we were reading the file. Once we're done with writing, we have to close the file object. We do that by saying f.close, and the file has now been closed.